द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन आफ्टर टॉकिंग अबाउट और आफ्टर लर्निंग अबाउट द कंटिन्यूअस रैंडम वेरिएबल और द डिस्क्रीट रैंडम वेरिएबल फॉर अ वेरिएबल एक्स और अ रैंडम वेरिएबल वाई वी विल बी नाउ लर्निंग और डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द जॉइंट डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. Also, here also, in case of joint distribution, it is categorized into two. One of the random variable is termed as discrete random variable, and another random variable is termed as continuous random variable. So, initially, we talk about the joint distribution of the discrete random variable. The joint probability function or joint probability distribution of discrete random variable. See, in case of discrete random variable, the probability what we are calculating at capital X equal to small x, which is denoted by small f of x, is called as probability distribution or probability mass function or joint probability function. In case of continuous random variable, it is called as probability function or probability density function. Here, in case of joint, it will be termed in a different way, right? So, joint probability function or joint probability distribution of discrete random variable. In case of concentrating only on one random variable, we will be looking after at two random variables. So, let x and y be two discrete random variables. Then, small f of xy, which represents the probability or a joint probability function, this actually represents probability of random variable x at small x. This actually represents the probability of capital Y, the random variable capital Y at small y, which is called as joint probability function. So instead of having a random variable capital X and its probability as small x, we will be having a probability joint probability function denoted by f of xy, which means that probability of a random variable capital X at small x, probability of a random variable at a small y, provided it fulfills the certain condition. What is that condition? In place of f of x greater than equal to 0, I will have the joint probability function f of xy greater than equal to 0. In case of summation over x, f of x equal to 1, I will have the joint probability function summation over x, summation over y, f of xy is equal to 1. So here we need to keep in mind two different things, that x and y be the two discrete random variables, then its joint probability function. Here instead of probability function, we will be calling it as a joint probability function. And how is that joint probability function given by? Joint probability function will be f of xy greater than equal to 0. The first and foremost condition it should satisfy: summation over x, summation over y, f of xy is equal to 1. Summation over x as well as y together, the grand total should come out as 1. Means for all corresponding values of x as well as all corresponding values of y, the total should come out as 1. Suppose x assumes the values as x1, x2 up to xm. I denote the random variables represented for capital X as x1, x2 up to xm. And y assumes the values as y1, y2 up to yn. Then in general, when I have to denote the joint probability function f of xi comma yj, I will be varying from 1 to m and j will be varying from 1 to m. See, x is taking the value x1, x2, xm. So if I am writing f of xi comma yj, probability will be calculated at x equal to xi. But how is I varying from 1, 2, 3 up to m? How is yj represented by? Yj is for the probability for random variable capital Y. But how is j moving as? J is moving as 1, 2, 3 up to n. So this particular notation represents the probability of the event when x is equal to xi and y is equal to yj. Here you can have 2, 3 values for x, 2, 3 values of y. So that will be correspondingly paired for calculation of the probability for the given function. So pairing is done in a proper way so that every value for x is paired with every value of y, and accordingly we are able to get the probability function for the joint function f of xy, which we call it as a joint probability function. Now, in place of this normal probability function, here the words used are marginal probability function, wherein jab apan bolte the wahan par ki we have to calculate the probability density function or probability mass function, that word is now replaced by marginal probability function. There will be two different quantities. One will be called as marginal probability function for random variable x, which is given by f1 of xi. The marginal probability function of random variable y will be denoted by f2 of yj. Now, in general, I am using the notation xi and yj. Actually, it should be x1, x2 up to xm. It should be y1, y2 up to ym. But to synchronize it or to compile it, I am just using the notation as marginal probability function for random variable x will be given by f1 of xi, marginal probability function for random variable y will be given by f2 of yj. Now, how to calculate this probability f marginal probability function f1 of xi? I know that this f1 of xi will represent the probability for capital X equal to xi, right? And how is this to be calculated? This is to be calculated for a fixed xi, for a fixed yj, for all corresponding values of x. So how is it moving from? J is moving from 1 to n. Or xi kaisa hai? Aapka fix hai. Xi is fixed. Means I am calculating the value or the summation or the pair for fixed xi and varying yj. Yani x1 agar fix hai, to y1, y2, y3, y4, y5. This will be the pair which will be formed for the probability, joint probability function, which is denoted by f of xi comma yj. Summation is over j. Means what is changing? Y is changing. What is fixed? Xi is fixed. That and I is varying from 1 to n. So that particular summation of xi with all yj will be nothing but the marginal probability function for x equal to xi. When we will be writing it into the tabular form, it will be more clear. I am coming to that particular point. Marginal probability function of random variable y is given by f2 of yj, where probability y is equal to yj. Now here, when I am calculating the marginal probability function of y, y will be fixed and I will be varying I. So summation is over I is equal to 1 to n. J is all values from 1 to n. So yj is fixed. I am varying all y. So correspondingly, sare y ke liye mera sara x ka pair banega, and that will be termed as marginal probability function for a random variable y, which is given by f2 of yj. But looking at these particular terms mathematically is not that convincing unless and until we try to draw the joint probability table. So always remember, may be the case of a joint probability function or joint probability distribution for a continuous random variable or a discrete random variable, we will always be drawing a table. Now, how the table will be drawn? Table will be called as joint probability table. Here we take the row form as x, random variable row x will be taken in the row, random variable y will be taken in the column form, right? So you form the rows as x1, x2 up to xn, because in general it was xi. And how is xi? I is moving from 1, 2, 3, 4 up to m. How is yj? J is moving from 1, 2, 3 up to n. So here you take the values y1, y2 up to yn. What is this pair coming out as? This pair is coming out as x1 comma y1. What is this pair coming out as? F of x1 comma y2. What is this pair coming out as? F of x1, x2 comma y1. This pair is f of x2 comma y2. In general, this pair will be f of x1 comma yn. This pair will be x2 comma yn. This will be xm comma y1, xm comma y2. In general, it will be xm comma yn. So with the help of the table, it will be very easy and convenient for us to draw the joint probability table or to get the joint probability table from the given probability function in the form of pairs. Now, how I will calculate as per the definition the marginal probability function of x? What they are saying, vary y for all corresponding x and add them. For this random variable denoted by x1, different y are taken into consideration. So summation of all this particular row where x1 is fixed and all y are taken into account, at the end I am getting the product as, or I am getting the outcome as f of x1, which is called as marginal probability function of x. For x2, correspondingly I have added this function for various y moving from 1, 2, 3 up to n. So this is at the end the summation what I am getting, or the outcome I am getting, is denoted by f1 of x2, which is called as marginal probability function of x. Similarly, for the last value xm, f of xm comma y1 plus f of xm comma y2 plus f of xm comma yn will be summation of all this, will be denoted by f1 of xn, which is called as marginal probability of x. So ultimately kya yaad rakhna hai, marginal probability function of x is nothing but summation of all particular elements related to the first row. X2 ke liye marginal probability function will be summation of all particular elements in the row with corresponding element x2. For marginal probability function of y, you should take the summation of column. What they have said here, yj is fixed, where j is moving from 1 to n. Kya move ho raha hai? I equal to 1 to n. Y1 is fixed in every case. Kya vary ho raha hai? X1, X2, Xm. So summation of this particular column is giving you F2 of Y1. Summation of this particular column will give you F2 of Y2. Summation of this particular column will give you F2 of Yn. So this is called as marginal probability function of Y. So after drawing the joint probability table, one additional column and one additional row will be calculated, where the additional column will give you the corresponding marginal probability function for X. The bottom row will be giving you the addition of the column, which will be called as marginal probability function for Y. Mind well, summation of all these values in the column as well as row form, the grand total should always be equal to 1. Here I have mentioned that summation over X, summation over Y, f of xy is always equal to 1. So either you go horizontally, add them vertically and horizontally, that's total, or the summation should always be equal to 1. It should never exceed 1. This is what the pictorial representation for the joint probability function f of xy is, which exists for a random variable capital X as well as the random variable capital Y. Now, kya bola hai unhone hint mein? What they have said here, the marginal probability function of X equal to XI can be obtained by adding all entries in a row corresponding to XI. We will be adding all entries in a row to get the marginal probability function for X. And marginal probability function of y equal to yj can be obtained by adding all the entries in the column corresponding to yj. So therefore, we will be calculating the marginal probability function for x as well as marginal probability function for y. The summation of these both entries, column wise and row wise, should be always equal to 1. It should never exceed 1. So further, summation I equals to 1 to n, f1 of xi is equal to 1. All corresponding entries addition of marginal probability function of x is 1. All corresponding entries addition for marginal probability function of y is also 1. So together in totality, summation I equals to 1 to n, j equals to 1 to n, f of xi comma yj is equal to 1. So grand total horizontally as well as vertically together should always be equal to 1. That is how they have explained us. Now this was the marginal probability function for x and marginal probability function for y. Now we discuss about the distribution function, the joint distribution function, which is denoted by capital F of xy for a discrete random variable. See, for a discrete random variable, the distribution function was denoted by capital F of x. And how it was calculated? It was calculated by showing the various cumulative addition for the given function and the range. So similarly, here also the distribution function, rather to be more specific, we call it as joint distribution function capital F of xy, which is given by P x less than equal to x, y less than equal to y, which is from minus infinity to x and minus infinity to y. So summation will be taken for f of uv, where u is up to x and v is up to y. See, up to x we have to take the distribution function, but what is the extreme left end of this particular real number line? From minus infinity. So I will go up to from minus infinity up to x for x as well as y. For y also I will go from minus infinity up to y. So capital F of xy, which is a joint distribution function, is a sum of all entries for which they are less than equal to x or less than equal to y. So this will be denoting the joint distribution function for the joint probability function F of xy. As here I am restricting the value up to x and up to y, I call this particular function as F of uv. In place of f of xy, I am writing down the function as f of uv. Now one additional term is involved over here, which we call it as independent variables. Now what do you mean by independent variables? If the events x equal to xi and the event y equal to yj are independent events for all I and j, then x and y are called as independent random variables. If these events are independently happening, then the random variables correspondingly x and y are called as independent random variables. But mathematically, going as per the definition, it will be very difficult for me to understand every time. So what I do, I just apply the rule or the formula. What that formula is, if for individual probability or a joint probability at x equal to x and y equal to y, I am getting the product of individual probability functions or marginal probability functions, I say that the random variables are independent random variables. The joint probability function at x equal to x and y equal to y is equal to the independent product of the probabilities at x equal to x or x, y equal to y. That is, f of xy is a product of marginal probability function of x and marginal probability function of y. That is, a joint probability function is equal to the product of marginal probability function of x and y. Then we say that x and y are independent random variables. Otherwise, we call x and y as dependent random variables. Is this point clear to everybody? So whenever in case of joint probability function or in any example related to the joint probability function, we are asked to find out the